Hello, friends. Today I'm going to work with a basic table in Word that has not been prepped for accessibility. I'll convert it to a PDF file and then make that PDF file accessible. I'm also going to demo various examples of the file with an NVDA screen reader to help you better understand what our visitors using screen readers would hear in each example. In the first example, we start with a Word document that contains a basic table, which is only 3 rows, so we can speed through the example. But you need to imagine the table having lots of rows and pay attention when the reader gets into the body of the table. You will hear repetition and understand how easy it could be to get lost in the table and not know what row you were on. Here's how it sounds with the NVDA screen reader.
Page 1, my apartment's January. These are the apartments for January. Table with 5 rows and 3 columns. Level 1, row 1, column 1, date, column 2, customer, column 3, amount, column 4, row 2, column 1, January 1, 2016, column 2, Johnny Ramjet, column 3, $400, column 4, row 3, column 1, January 2, 2016, column 2, Little Jimmy, column 3, $350, column 4, row 4, column 1, January 8, 2016, column 2, Betty Late Pay, column 3, $400, column 4, row 5, column 1, total, column 2, $1,150, column 3, out of table.
I need to point out a couple of things about what you just heard. First, you need to know where the problems can occur. The example only contains 3 rows, and the data is very easy to hear with a screen reader since I spelled out months, names, and added a dollar amount. The 3 fields are easy to differentiate. A better example of the problem would have been if I had rows that only contained numbers. You would have a hard time associating which column you were on because the column name is not repeated. NVDA, by default, does a very nice job at least repeating the column and row numbers. But even that would be difficult because it would have said, row 2, column 1, California, row 2, column 2, 20, row 2, column 3, 80, row 2, column 4, 10. You see how tough that would be if you couldn't see it, trying to associate the number value with the type of column it is? In Windows Eyes, which is a Microsoft endorsed reader, the problem is even worse, as their default mode on that would have said on the same row too, California, 20, 80, 10. 20, 80, 10, what? I mean, it's tough. If my example would have contained all numbers like the one I'm showing now, the reader would have been even harder to understand because by default they read pretty fast. So let's get back to my example. After creating the Word doc, I created the PDF, and just to give you a baseline, let's listen to the PDF in the NVDA reader.
My apartments, January. These are the apartments for January. Table with 5 rows and 2 columns. Row 1, column 1, date. Column 2, customer. Column 3, amount. Row 2, column 1, January 1, 2016. Column 2, Johnny Ramjet. Column 3, $400. Row 3, column 1, January 2, 2016. Column 2, Little Jimmy. Column 3, $350. Row 4, column 1, January 8, 2016.
So the thing to notice there is the reader did a nice job of being consistent between the non-accessible Word and PDF documents. Next, let's make this PDF accessible. Hopefully you've already watched the other posted video on PDF accessibility, because the thing we're going to focus on here is just making that basic table accessible and then hearing the difference in the screen reader. We're starting out in Adobe Acrobat 11, and this is Acrobat Professional. Go to the Tools menu, and we'll go down to where it says Touch Up Reading Order, and that pops up the Touch Up Reading Order dialog. And then we're going to look in the upper portion of the where it says Paragraph, and we'll highlight the first heading area there where it says My Apartments. We'll drag over the entire area there, and then we'll click the heading 1, making that first one a heading. We'll repeat that for the second where it says January, and we'll click on heading 2. To clean up, we'll click that bottom paragraph, and then we'll click the background button to remove it. Then we're going to click on the table, and we'll click Table Editor from the dialog, and now we're going to get into some table editing. Keeping in mind the problem that we had was that we weren't repeating those top 3 columns, date, customer, and amount. And that's what we want to cure now. So what we're going to do is we're going to highlight inside those three fields. And then we're going to right click. And it'll say Table Cell Properties. And we're going to identify these as header. And we're going to select the scope that says column. And then say OK. That makes all three of those identify as headers. We're going to do the same with that row on the bottom where we'll collect header, we'll call it a header cell, and then we'll select it instead as a row because we're wanting it to go across and get the other the $1,150 number. Next, we're going to go to each one of them and then name them. So the header cell will name date of the first one. We're right clicking in each of these cells, as you can see. Then we just go down into the ID of each one and put what it's supposed to say. Customer in this case. And finally in number three, we'll say that it is the amount. We'll finish up by saying total in the bottom. And what we're doing here is this is what is then read back. And instead of saying row or column one or column two, it may still say column one, but it's going to say column one date and really lets them know. Now this is the tedious part in PDF. There is no quick escape from this. You have to go to each one of these cells then, right click on it, and then choose there. You're seeing that if you choose the plus after you right click, it gives you the option of all that you have identified so far. And so what we're doing is we're just right clicking in each of the data fields and identifying what the related column is. Or header is. So we do that tedious part through everyone we identify, and that's how that goes. We gonna fast forward to the end of it where we do the last cell, which is the amount. And what we're doing in that last corner cell is we're checking amount, and then we're going back in on the total, or we're gonna do it again after we've done the first column, and we're going to go to the list again. This time we're going to select total from it and add it. And now we've got both on that last field. It just identifies the very end of having the total amount. That's as far as we're going here, and then we just save the document, and then we'll listen to it in NVDA and see the difference.
Heading level 1, my apartments. Heading level 2, January. These are the apartments for January. Table with 5 rows and 2 columns. Row 1, column 1, date. Column 2, customer. Column 3, amount. Row 2, date. Column 1, January 1, 2016. Customer. Column 2, Johnny Ramjet. Amount. Column 3, $400. Row 3, date. Column 1, January 2, 2016. Customer. Column 2, Little Jimmy. Amount. Column 3, $350. Row 4, date. Column 1, January 8, 2016. Customer. Column 2, Betty. Late pay. Amount. Column 3, $400. Row 5, date. Column 1, total. Amount. Column 2, $1,150.
So now we have a PDF accessible document that is going to sound good the way we want it to in the different screen readers that are on the market. Next, we're going to do the read out loud functionality in PDF. And the reason I'm wanting to show you this is that we're going to do this on the exact document that we just saved. And I want you to hear this, the read out loud functionality, because you're going to find out that it is not a true screen reader, that it is going to ignore the accessibility stuff that we put into it. So listen to the read out loud functionality.
My apartments, January. These are the apartments for January. Date, customer, amount, January 1st, 2016, Johnny Rampjet, $400, January 2nd, 2016, Little Jimmy, $350, January 8th, 2016, Betty, late pay, $400, total $1,150,